For learning about something such as handling glassware, you have to be in the laboratory so that you can feel it, physically touch it, and possibly risk breaking it. So we've got some on-campus teaching labs. But that's not easy to widen participation if we want to reach people 24/7, if we want to give them the experience of working in laboratories without having to travel. This lab we've set up as a studio laboratory so that we can get people involved in real time in the laboratory, broadcasting to them, and they can get up close to the laboratory bench. The OpenSTEM labs have got various facilities associated with space and astronomy. Just behind me are a couple of our telescopes. The first one is a radio telescope, and that works during the daytime or at night, wherever we happen to be looking, if it's in view, and it doesn't care too much about what the atmospheric conditions are like because the radio signals go straight through. Behind that, there's an optical telescope. Now, the thing about optical telescopes is, for a start, they don't work in the daytime because there's too much light in the sky, of course, and they've got to look through the atmosphere, and even the atmosphere is pretty difficult to see through when you're doing astronomical observations. Much better to go up a mountain. So we have a telescope very much like that one up a mountain in Tenerife. In fact, we've got two up there. And there is about 2,400 meters above sea level, much less atmosphere to look through, and a much greater view of the stars.
We have two facilities in Tenerife, Pirate and Caos. The large one, Pirate, is research-grade instrumentation, also used for PhD research projects. The smaller one, Caos, we open up to the general public to be used via telescope.org.
The idea behind the OpenSTEM labs is that we can bring students to the lab, or bring the labs to students, no matter where they are. We can take students to telescopes up mountains, and we can take them onto the surface of planets, such as the surface of Mars, in here. We've set up this rover in the Mars shed so that students can work collaboratively, no matter where they are on the Earth, controlling it, sending it off on an exploration. In the OpenSTEM labs, we like to get students able to use cutting-edge equipment. And when it comes to microscopes, we have some pretty powerful optical and electron microscopes. We can look at details of a fly's wing, or we can look at impact craters on objects that have been exposed to micrometeorites.
It's a place for collaborative working, and it's open all hours.